The marking gauge is used to mark a line parallel to a straight edge. The marking gauge is made up of four main parts. Here we see the stem running the full length of the gauge, the stalk, the spur or point, and the thumb screw. I'm now going to take the marking gauge apart to give you a better view of each of the parts. So here we can see in better detail now the three main components of the marking gauge. We have the stem. I like to remember the stem as the stem of a flower. We have the spur, like spurs on a cowboy's boots. The spur has a point on one side which is used to scratch or mark into the wood. We then have the stalk, and I remember this by thinking of it as square like a stalk cube, and we have the hole for the thumb screw here. The stalk is the block which gets rested against the side of the wood to allow us to gain distance with the spur. The thumb screw locks everything into position and holds the size we wish to mark out with the marking gauge. Again, I'll reassemble, placing the stem into the stalk, and then the thumb screw screws into position to hold the stalk onto the stem. Now I can calculate and measure a distance between the spur and the stalk, and this will be the distance that I scribe on the wood. This can be adjusted by loosening the thumb screw and checking again with a rule, but you must remember always to check against the point of the spur and never the back edge of the spur where it meets the stem. That's the marking gauge. I'll now demonstrate how the marking gauge works when marking out a piece of wood. So once again we have the marking gauge and your best friend the pencil. Here we can see that I want to measure between the stalk and the point of the spur. So now I measure my set distance given in the working drawing. And for this I'll use 20mm. I tighten up the marking gauge thumb screw, and if the size isn't quite right, then I can tap the marking gauge at the bottom or the top on the desk to either widen or shorten the gap between the stalk and the spur. I then tighten up the thumb screw to make sure that it doesn't move. Holding the marking gauge in one hand, I then place it firmly and squarely against the side of my wood. I want to measure a line down and across the whole length of the wood, and the same on the top of the wood. So I take the marking gauge, place the stalk against the wood, and then gently run down the wood with the spur, creating a small line in my wood, invisible at this point, but then the pencil can be used to highlight this line. This line is now parallel to the edge of the wood. I'll do the same, create the line down on the side of the wood, 20mm already set, and scratching my line with the marking gauge. You may need to go over it once or twice, just to get the desired depth for your pencil, and then gently run the pencil along the side of the wood. Then I'm marking out 45 degree scrap lines, because what I want to do is remove this wood using other tools. And that's how to mark out using a marking gauge.